And they always knew, it's sort of like the witches of Eastwick, except it was called, what do they call that? Where the, there's, in the town, I think it's called the Benedetto?
Oh. They were chosen for sailors because they would reputedly couldn't drown.
See, that's good. But the reason they can't drown, those who are born with the amniotic sac, is related to the other legend about them, which is not only will they be lucid dreamers, but they will be the one who steers the plasma above the town. And there's a whole legend in Italy about this. It's a big, complicated, long story. But it has to do with the fact that the coherence of your aura will be greater if, as you say, they come out of if you're healthy enough to come out of the womb with the amniotic sac whole. Because you see, then the birthing process, the baby actually makes their own choice of when to unpack from the long wave to the short wave, as it were.
I have a question.
Yes, go ahead.
You showed those graphs of emotion, love, hate, joy, anger, I think. And they seem very similar. And I'm just trying to understand, since those emotions seem to be very different.
Yes, well, it's a fun thing. I recommend the book. It's called Centics, Touch of the Emotions. And the emotion for joy reaches max pressure at 1/6 into the duration of the event. And you see the bounce back. Mm. And 1/6 creates a form of wave order. Anger, however, reaches max pressure at 1/7 into duration of the event. No bounce back. And perfect destructive wave interference. I repeat, anger is electrically perfect destructive wave interference. Sometimes very useful. You got to kick the money changers out of the temple. You use a little anger, right? But if you try to hold on to that, it is, by electrical definition, self-destructive. Mm-hmm. The wave for hate is 1/3, by the way, which is also destructive wave interference. And love is 1/5. Now, somebody said, what is fear? Actually, it's not in the book. You know why? Fear is stop the world, I want to get off. Resistance to all wave shapes. You see? That's why they say fear is the mind killer, because fear is the spin killer, actually. And it's spin that creates mind. And that is our next subject.
Well, I had a quick question.
Please.
Too,
go ahead.
I've heard through some teachings also that you should conceive. Give birth exactly where you conceive the baby. Is there any science behind that? So if you make love, that's where you should, you know, the baby should come through, because that's where, you know, conceived, and then you give birth in that same spot. Is there any science behind that?
It's a beautiful thought. I believe the principle in Aboriginal lore is called the Abraxas point. And you know, the Aboriginal woman, the moment she feels a baby in her womb, she runs to the shaman, and they go and make a magnetic map on a stone of the magnetic lines of the place where the mother was first aware she had a baby. And that stone with that magnetic map becomes the title deed to that child, showing them the land they're in charge of holding together in their dreaming. Now, we know, particularly for women, even more so than men, that returning to the place of your birth gives electrical leverage to your DNA. And that's something we were supposed to discuss today anyway. The sequence by which your DNA braids recursively, we have our excuse to return to our curriculum for a second, but the sequence by which your DNA braids recursively it braids from thread to string to rope to fat rope 7 times. Until it, as the plot thickens, it turns inside out and becomes Lord of the Ring, called implosion, and a soul, actually. Now, that process of imploding as it braids in response to human bliss, you can measure the presence of the enzyme that does that braiding, what Glenn Ryan did at my suggestion. So the DNA is imploding and sucking in the charge of its environment and becoming its environment electrically, a fractal thereof. So if your ancestors walked barefoot on the same land for 100 generations, it's much more likely that you will be a lucid dreamer. And that's what all the ETs want to be. You know what a wannabe is? That's a wannabe. They want to be what you are. So the reason, the physics of the reason that if your ancestors walked on the same land for enough generations is that you'll be a lucid dreamer is because your aura is more coherent, and therefore you can propagate that plasma. And that's the physics of having a soul, and that's That's the Groundhog Day our ancestors screwed up. So we're doing Groundhog Day in that one. But so the principle of actually returning to the place of conception and birth and then shamanic death, for example, the Aboriginal was taught you must never leave this land. That was actually an old Draco idea. But the old Draco ideas had some mistakes. For example, the men and the women had different languages. Read Anton Parks. That's how the Aboriginals had different languages for the men and the women. The caste system in India and the Aboriginal marriage laws came from the same place, Alpha Draconis. And their mistake was thinking that any DNA that changes is defective. So the principle is actually fractality. So the baby would choose where to be born if the baby had a choice, where the magnetic lines look like a rose, to put it very simply. And the magnetic map of Prague is a rose, Bohemia, Bohem. Bo means Anki's line, basically. Yes, any questions? Yes. The song line or dreaming track was measured by Rob Gourlay, very helpful work. He showed that they were very successful in creating a very successful commercial business by making a magnetic map that's in color here. But then they realized that the lines in white here of extreme magnetic conductivity were literally what the locals, and this is Braidwood outside of Canberra, they were what the locals called the song line or the dreaming track. So it's now quite well understandable that magnetic flux permissivity and magnetic radiance are in fact what the Aboriginals were calling song line or dreaming track. So this is one of the reasons, reason number 180, why you need a magnetic map of your bed, because it's going to tell you where you can go when you dream, actually, and also give you an idea of where you can go when you die.
How do you make that?
Well, it's Intro to Dowsing 101, and I'm sure there's good dowsers around here. But the physics of dowsing, you know, Z.B. Harvillick's work, isolated the glands involved, and we know a lot of that physics as well. The summary is that your blood was designed to bend the magnetic line. Sante. Asaan, right? And the ability of your blood to bend a magnetic line increases the more you have bliss, because the recursive braiding becomes phase coherent. You get a soul. In Star Wars, it was called microchloridians in the blood. In Montauk, it was called boson 7. It was the extent to which your DNA is phase coherent. And any genetic engineer worth his salt would actually be measuring the spectral frequencies of DNA, and you'd know who was a lucid dreamer and a time traveler. Phase coherence in DNA is not a mystery. And so that is indication of the ability to douse, actually, feel a magnetic line. And we work with dowsers who... they can find water anywhere, primary water. That's a whole other subject. And that's what Rob Gourlay did, was he translated this into this language of primary water. And he even got the Australian government to change the laws, because all the laws about who can drill where were built around knowledge of surface water. They didn't even know what primary water, the deep rock or captive water table, is. It makes an electric field, which is phase conjugate. That's measurable, and that's dowsing. And that is fractal, and that's the earth's blood, and it's called sante. And if you can't feel it, you know, you're having trouble feeling. So it is appropriate. And just a very simple, I mean, I'm sure you all know some place in the neighborhood that has strong energy, right? Go to wherever that is and walk very slowly like this, hands like this. You can use rods, but you don't need them. And where you feel the tingle in your finger, the presence, the warmth, the presence, and you get used to that, and it becomes a language. And eventually you realize you're feeling the blood of mother. That's what magnetism is. In fact, it's where the word comes from, magna, as in magsita, the whole language of... So, songline dreaming track is a language for the fact that the magnetic lines of Earth actually is a blood of the collective mind. For example, when Professor Callahan showed that if the magnetic line between village A and village B breaks, you can predict that war is going to break out. It's that simple. He measured it. He went to Israel, Yugoslavia, Ireland. When the magnetic line breaks, that's when you get war. You fix that magnetic line, you make peace. Because there is no higher definition for peacemaking than that centripetal force of self-organization which fractality creates. And that is the origin of our curriculum for teaching peacemaking as science, goldenmean.info/peaceuniversity. So when we describe the principle of self-organization in general, We are at that time describing the principle of peacemaking in general. Yes? Now, we were supposed to go on and talk about measuring brain waves for bliss and all kinds of fun stuff. I see that it's about 11 minutes after 3, Dan. Another 15 or something, 10, 15?
Yeah.
Okay. So just to try to finish the thought that we started out here. See, now that you have some sense of why it's so much fun to understand the origin of all centripetal and self-organizing forces, gravity, life, love, color, bliss, enlightenment, immortality, alchemy, fusion, all of these mysteries, every single one of them requires understanding only one simple geometry. So then my job was to give you a few science examples to try to show you how beautiful that metaphor fits. The first one is the studying the nature of human bliss. So I invented a device, it's called the Bliss Tuner. Many of you have seen that device. And basically, here is your brain learning to have enlightenment. It's called bliss. Actually, ANZ Bank in Melbourne is using my system to teach bank managers, but we call it something else there. We call it peak perception. Here is a lady here in Byron, actually, having a bliss experience. She's going, And you have 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 5 harmonics in golden mean ratio as to frequency. This is alpha, beta, delta, theta, right hemisphere, left hemisphere. So the reason you call that bliss or enlightenment, you know, why you pay so much money to go to the rave and the doof, it is basically that there is a musical recipe, and the musical recipe is how to teach 2 pine cones how to kiss. And that's called phase conjugation in brain waves. And then, so I advanced the theory that phase conjugation is the cause of perception. We know in physics that when you take 2 lasers and cause them to conjugate phases, that was the first time physics discovered self-organization. That is the physics of perception. So your brain waves make this golden ratio, same picture, 2 pine cones kissing. And that's called phase conjugation and the origin, the constructive aspect of visual perception. Steve Lehar is another physicist, actually a neuroscientist, who agrees that phase conjugation is the cause of perception. Very simply put, you sit under the sacred tree, you can measure the air there, it's more fractal. We're about to describe why fractal air is the only reason rainbows exist. Very measurable, same physics. So the reason your perception gets so much sharper under the sacred tree is because the electric field is centripetal. Now apply that to your child's classroom. If you take out the poisonous fluorescent light, any light that does not have the harmonics of the sun, hydrogen, fusion, fractal, that light is evil. Sorry, Martin. But it's a light whose harmonics actually prevent the possibility of attention, because attention is defined only as that centripetal fusion possibility. So you yank out the poisonous fluorescent lights, you install sunlight, and attention span goes way up. It's very measurable. It's been done. The book John Ott, Health and Light. So the physics is simple. The cause of attention is the centripetal force itself. You can apply that to your children's classroom and end attention deficit for real. Neurofeedback, brainwave harmonics, diet, and an environment of charge. You got to eliminate the dead air, eliminate the metal in the environment, and most of it, and you need to eliminate a lot of the electrosmog, and then get natural frequencies. The Steiner schools had that right. They said the child shall only touch wood and stone and natural fabrics, and golly, did they have that right. Because that's the only area where your aura can unpack. It's very, very simple. Those are phase conjugating dielectrics. A living field effect. So that allows the child's aura to grow and invites their aura to grow. You send your child on dead food into a dead school with dead ideas. Oops.